I'm Dr. Michelle Lee, a board-certified ophthalmologist and cataract surgeon. I really appreciate every thoughtful comment and question left on the comments below, and today I thought we'd answer some of the most common questions I get both on my channel as well as in my clinical practice about cataracts and cataract surgery. Let's get started. What are factors or risk factors that can make cataract surgery more complicated? I get this question a lot, and I want to preface this by saying that even routine cataract surgery has a small risk of a complication during the surgery. There are factors that will increase the risk of a complication during surgery. Putting off cataract surgery for a very long time will result in a denser lens. Having a denser lens will require more energy and more time inside the eye during the surgery. More energy and time inside the eye will increase the healing time as well as the risk of a complication happening during the surgery. Any history of eye surgeries, such as retina surgeries, can also slightly increase the chance of a complication during surgery. Also, any trauma to the head, face, or the eyes, such as a car accident. It is really important that you tell your surgeon ahead of time if you've had a history of trauma or a history of previous eye surgery so that they can be prepared to address any possible complications that may arise. Another factor that can complicate your cataract surgery is if there's anything that can obstruct the view to your surgery. This can include corneal scars as a result from infection or inflammation, or swelling of the cornea due to a cornea disease. Your surgeon will need to examine your eyes so they can note any obstruction of view, and sometimes you will require additional surgery such as a cornea transplant, or the surgeon may use visual aids to assist them during the surgery to increase their visibility. On top of that, there is a genetic condition that can result in an increased risk of cataract surgery. A cataract, which is a cloudy lens inside the eye, is actually held in place inside the eye with strings called zonules. There is a genetic condition called pseudoexfoliation, where the strings that hold the lens in place are much more brittle and fragile. If there is enough stress or tension on the zonules, there is a chance that that lens complex will not be stable, and thus there will be a higher chance of a complication. Lens stability may result in a complication even years after cataract surgery. Your cataract evaluation with your eye surgeon will include a thorough examination of the eye to look for any signs of any of these risk factors. Make sure you tell your surgeon about any previous surgeries or conditions that you are aware of so that your surgeon can help prepare for your case and also so they can better prepare you for expectations after surgery. Can you combine cataract surgery with other procedures such as glaucoma surgeries and cornea surgeries? Yes, we frequently combine surgeries for cornea and glaucoma together with cataract surgery. As a cornea surgeon, I specialize in both cataract surgery and cornea transplantation surgery. And one of the most common surgery combinations will be a combination of cataract surgery with a partial thickness cornea transplant. If you require both surgeries, there are lots of advantages of doing both at the same time, which include a cumulative lower risk of complications or infection, as well as some time and cost savings on your end. If you have mild to moderate glaucoma, many cataract surgeons will offer minimally invasive glaucoma surgery or MIG surgeries. This can address both the cataract and the glaucoma at the same time. Having a MIG surgery can help you potentially eliminate one of your eye drops or act as additional pressure lowering if needed. What is the best lens for cataract surgery on the market? This is a very subjective question, and every surgeon will have their favorite lenses and platforms that they use frequently. So my answers here are purely based on my personal experiences as a cataract surgeon. I'm always trying new lenses, and I try to offer what I think are the best lenses available on the market to my patients. And as of filming, my favorite platform is the Technis platform by Johnson & Johnson. My favorite standard lens in this platform is called the EyeHands lens. I really like this lens because it's marketed as a monofocal lens. It has no additional cost to the patient. It does have a little bit of range to it. So whereas a traditional monofocal lens will only allow you to see well for distance, sometimes my patients can see distance, dashboard, maybe even the computer with this lens. For patients who want a full range of vision, such as distance, computer, and reading, and have no contraindications, I will offer multifocal lenses, specifically a trifocal lens. And the two that I am currently offering to my patients are the Panoptics lens by Alcon and the Synergy lens by Johnson & Johnson. I compared these lenses in a little bit more detail in a prior video. In general, the Panoptics lens has a slight edge to distance vision, whereas the Synergy lens has a very clear edge for reading vision. Multifocal lenses are not for everybody though, so it is really important that you talk to your provider about whether you're a good candidate or not for this type of lens prior to proceeding with surgery. Another favorite type of lens is a light adjustable lens. And I love offering this lens, especially to patients who are very picky or patients who have had prior eye surgeries such as LASIK or PRK. This lens is made out of a light-sensitive material that can be adjusted even after implantation. I just made a video all about light adjustable lenses that you can check out if you're interested in this platform. Are there any new lenses coming out on the market? There is a new lens that came out in July 2022 called the IC8 Aphthera lens. This is a lens that has a smaller aperture that allows for an extended depth of vision and is placed in your non-dominant eye after the dominant eye is set for distance vision to allow you to potentially be spectacle independent. This lens uses the pinhole effect, which allows rays of light to pass through your eye without being bent by any cornea astigmatism or irregularities, thus allowing a greater range of vision. This is especially exciting technology for patients with very irregular corneas, for example, those with keratoconus or previous refractive surgeries like LASIK, PRK, or RK, because there is going to be less distortion of light entering the eye. This is possibly a great option for people with light sensitivity or issues with glare while providing a range of vision. As of filming, this is not indicated for those with retinal diseases such as macular degeneration. I would also not advise this lens be used on patients with glaucoma or any kind of central corneal opacity. What do you think cataract surgery will be like in the future? So medicine is an ever-evolving field, and the only thing I know for sure is that the way that I do surgery and practice right now will be very different at the end of my career in about 20 to 30 years. Our current methods for cataract surgery are short, safe, and effective, and we've come a long way from manual couching to large incision cataract surgery to small incision cataract surgery to phaco emulsification, which is what we do today. One thing that I hope happens in my career is that we will have more options for preventative care. As we find out more about cataracts and how they develop, we'll have more recommendations, supplements, and even treatment like eye drops to help slow or prevent cataract surgery. I still believe there will be a role for cataract surgery in the future. I see the field gravitating towards automation of the step. Now we even have a laser that can do some of the steps of cataract surgery, such as creating wounds and softening the lens. I only imagine that we're going to have ways to automate more and more of these steps to the point where there would be an option of a mostly automatic cataract surgery. I hope you found this interesting and helpful. As always, I appreciate any questions or comments you leave down below. I'll do my best to answer them. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.